Thank you. here to this place. Me, well you bear this in silk dye of Evelyn, and you, James Ennis, honest patriot, thrown in here with half a hundred other unfortunates, crowded together with hardly room to breathe for by exercise. Short of commons, just bread and water, and no air. The heat is unsurpassed, the stench of our unwashed bodies and fundamental waste, unbelievably sickening. This in my town of Aberdeen, and yet I'm treated like some common thief or importunate beggar. Why has it come to this? How well remember with what pride I put up the cacard and joined with John Moyer Stonywood's troop marching to the castle gate. Sick ongoings there. Staffoni sending in every direction for the promised counsellors and magistrates that were not the bull of persuasion. Sick rejoicing as we raised our glasses to the prince and the cause. I was some unhappy when certain of our company did forcibly all wine doom plot his Morrison's throat, he steadfastly refusing to join in with this. For he was a good man, though misguided in his loyalties. Aye, busy days. A mad ride to Italy to unload the weaponry from the Spanish ship. Elation on hearing the news of the victorious march into England. And, oh, the sadness. Aye, and despair. When the rumours started of things going amiss at dark. And the retreat. Then he arrived, His Royal Highness the Duke of Cumberland, with all his troops, swaggering, bullying, attacking over houses, and hell made a burgess of the city, raising a battalion of so-called loyal citizens for the defence of the tomb. Men posted on the steeples of this very building and the kirks to spy upon their bells, and searching everywhere, even the presses and closets in the Marshall College broken open. And you, James, filled with pride to be with old Prince of Cologne, we here heard the fearful news. Then came the reprisals. A chance for old hurts to be settled, neighbour denouncing neighbour. Sad days, nervous days, never knowing who next would be taken. Then came Cumberland's proclamation, and I doubt ye, and here I am. Your keepers, taunting us, delighting in conversing together in such tones as we cannot fail to hear about our likely future. Never have I known such poverty of body and soul, or such depth of desperation.